This week on Cracked Science, would you break up with your significant other if a DNA test told you you weren't compatible? Hey, this is Jonathan Jarre, and you're watching Cracked Science, the show from the McGill Office for Science and Society that separates sense from nonsense on the scientific stage. As Valentine's Day approaches, you may be asking yourself, is he or she the one? And hopefully, as you're asking this question, you are sitting next to your partner and not watching a random person from afar through a pair of binoculars. For some people, the answer to this question can be found in tarot cards, because what says eternal bliss better than the Ten of Pentacles? For others, it's in your DNA.
I want to introduce you to Jeremy Bluval. He is a biomedical engineer, and he created a company called Instant Chemistry. When you guys got here, each of you gave us a sample of your saliva so that we could get your DNA. Jeremy tested all of your DNA and then looked at issues of compatibility and your relationship. And we have the results.
In 2018, it's very easy to blind with science. Words like DNA, stem cells, and quantum are very shiny to the public, and they lend credibility to products that aren't even scientific. So let's pull back the curtain on DNA compatibility testing using Canadian company Instant Chemistry as our model. How it works is very straightforward. For $150 US, or approximately 185 Canadian dollars, you will receive two spit collection kits, one for you, one for your partner. You collect your spit and send it back to the company. They will extract your DNA and your partner's DNA from your saliva samples, look at specific parts of your genomes, and compare them. This is just like 23andMe, except that it targets different genes. For example, they will look at your HLA genes and send you a report that looks like this. HLA genes play a role in your immune system. They help your body differentiate between you and things like viruses that aren't you. A little bit like the teacher who writes her name on all of her pencils to make sure no one steals them. I remember you, Mrs. Vandenbroek. I remember you. In the report you get from Instant Chemistry, you will read this. Scientific research has shown that men and women are more sexually attracted to partners with HLA genes dissimilar to their own. The reasoning is that this couple would produce children with a more diverse and stronger immune system. As the co-founder of Instant Chemistry explained to Fox and Friends, this is based on the famous smelly t-shirt study, in which female volunteers were asked to smell t-shirts that had been worn by male volunteers.
These women were ranking the t-shirts to be most attractive were the ones that had the most dissimilar immune system genes to one another. And this kind of clicked in this researcher's head, and it started this whole field of, you know, the science of attraction.
The problem is twofold. First, the science. The smelly t-shirt study he quotes found something else. Women who were on the pill when smelling men's t-shirts actually had the opposite reaction. They preferred men who had similar HLA genes to their own. Over time, other studies were done on this phenomenon, and the results are all over the place. There doesn't seem to be a clear consensus on how smelling someone's HLA profile from their sweat affects mating choices. And the second problem is one of logic. If you can determine biocompatibility by smelling your partner's clothes, why, oh why, would you spend nearly $200 to be told what your nose can find out for free? And if you're congested, you do know that decongestants are much cheaper than Instant Chemistry, right? To be fair, the counter-argument is that Instant Chemistry was also aimed at single people. If you're still wrapping your head around online dating, wait until you hear about DNA dating. Instant Chemistry used to have a partnership with Singled Out that would use your DNA profile to match you up with an eligible date. Singled Out is apparently no more, but companies like DNA Romance and Faramore have picked up the slack. Now, Instant Chemistry does not stop at HLA genes. They also look at brain chemistry. They look at genes linked to emotional behavior, like serotonin, dopamine, and oxytocin. And based on which form of the gene you have, you will be labeled as an explorer, a thinker, or a worrier. I'm sorry, this sounds really familiar.
The only way our society can survive is for each of you to claim your rightful place. Today, you will take a test. that will help you discover who you truly are.
Your results were inconclusive.
This was supposed to tell me what to do. We're supposed to trust the test.
The test didn't work on you.
But what if you're divergent? But seriously, looking at that instant chemistry report, I can't help but think about abnegation, amity, candor, erudite, and dauntless. And just like Kirkus reviews call that a preposterous premise, the idea that major personality traits are determined by a G or an A in the DNA code of one gene is incredibly silly. In fact, it seems to be a return to the wave of genetic destiny covers that graced magazines in the 90s when we were sequencing the human genome. Nowadays, the media tends to be more nuanced in reporting these stories because you are not your genes. Your environment plays a significant part in who you become. Instant Chemistry has said that the results from their kit shouldn't be used to decide whether or not to break up, but rather to highlight aspects of your relationship you need to work on. But if your biological compatibility, like with the HLA genes, is way down, what can you do if you want children? And this may sound silly, but look at how absurd this was portrayed on ABC News.
Meet Maria and Tasso. They're both Greek-American, and they've been happily married for 5 years.
I guess I'm a little nervous if it shows that we're very much apart and we don't have a genetic makeup that would result in a fruitful partnership. You know, then I guess I don't know. It makes me nervous. Not that it would be over.
But what? So much of the marketing and media appearances related to this product circle around this nail-biting suspense over whether or not you are meant to be together. And as I've demonstrated, the science simply isn't there. If you want to know what makes or breaks a couple, let's look at what has been reported in the psychology literature. Some of the top reasons for divorce, for example, are infidelity, too much conflict, a lack of commitment, growing apart, substance abuse, and incompatible values and lifestyles. And I don't think Instant Chemistry or any other company can look at your genes and predict with complete accuracy whether or not you will cheat on your spouse. Using DNA to determine your compatibility with your spouse is a bit like feeling their skull to look for the secretiveness bump. I find it hard to place this kind of science hype much above the discredited theory of phrenology. I think James Sherlock put it best when he wrote about Instant Chemistry for Gizmodo. Choice of relationship partner is an immensely complex ballet of biology, culture, and circumstance. Genes are just one part of the story. If you are worried about your couple, you would be better off spending the money on a great night out, or maybe on a couple's therapist. If everything Instant Chemistry says about putting people into neat boxes, testing for compatibility, and reassuring you that it's just meant to help you work on your relationship, if all of this sounds familiar, it's because we've heard it all before.
These two signs are better off as friends, however, because Pisces is too indecisive for Virgo, and Virgo is too suffocating for a dreamy Pisces. Of course, as with all these combinations, any couple can make it work regardless of their zodiac sign. So don't let someone's birth date put you off. Just take this as a bit of advice about which areas of your and their personalities you might need to work on.
My recommendation this week is a long read, but one well worth it. It's an investigation by the Globe and Mail entitled Cracks in the Code: Why Mapping Your DNA May Be Less Reliable Than You Think. Carolyn Abraham covers the latest results from Canada's Personal Genome Project, which reveal that we may know less than we thought we knew about the impact of mutations on human health. I think the following quote sums it up nicely, quote, "In the genomic era, people keen to dip into their DNA should be comfortable curling up with ambiguity," end quote. Genes aren't destiny. Read this article to find out why. This video series is one small part of what our office does, so go to mcgill.ca/OSS to see what else we do to help separate sense from nonsense, and do subscribe to our newsletter. You can follow me on Twitter @CrackedScience and join us next time for science that may or may not be all it's cracked up to be.